Everyone, welcome to day 18th of August Lead Code Challenge. Today's question is numbers with same consecutive difference. Let's go through the question together. Return all the non-negative numbers of length n. The length is n here. Such that the absolute difference between any two consecutive digits is k. Note that every number in the answer must have leading zeros except for the number 0. For example, 01 has one leading 0 and is invalid, but 0 is valid. You may return the answer in any order. So let's understand the question by a few examples that are mentioned here. So this n here is 3 and k is 7. So the number of digits in each number should be 3. And the difference between n, every two consecutive numbers should be 7. The absolute value should be 7. Let's go through this example. So 8 minus 1 is 7. 1 minus 8 is minus 7 and hence it is 7. Similarly, 9 minus 2 is 7. 2 minus 9 is also 7. 0 minus 7 is minus 7, which is 7 again. Absolute difference is 7. 7 minus 0 is 7. 1 minus 8 is minus 7. Absolute difference is 7. 8 minus 1 is 7. 2 minus 9 is minus 7. Absolute difference. And so in all these cases, the absolute difference between every two consecutive digits in the numbers is 7. Hence, this forms a valid pattern. Also, there is a note written that 070 is not a valid number because it has leading zeros. The number turns out to becomes a two-digit number, and hence we will not incorporate this as part of the answer. Let's go through the other input. The input n is here is 2 and k is 1, and the data that becomes as an answer is 1, 0, 1, 2, 2, 1, 2, 3, 3, 2, and so on. So let's think about the solution now. Had it been the case that n would have been fixed in nature, we would have simply written multiple loops and found the required solution by looping it multiple times and generating our answer. But since n is variable here, we'll be using the DFS algorithm, kind of a DSL algorithm. You call it DFS, you call it recursion, you call it backtracking, all follow the same process. So we'll be using that. So today there is no trick of the solution. I'll be coding it and explaining the things to you. So let me define my integer list. So that will store the answer. Since I don't know the size of the list of my answer, so I cannot define it in the primitive manner. So this is a list that will be storing my answer. And I'll move ahead. I'll make a function named DFS. I'll pass n, k, my list, and the initial current value of the number, which will be a placeholder for storing, generate, building numbers, and that number will be 0 here. So defining my DFS function, private, return type will be void, integer k, list of integers, list, and integer current number. So n here denotes the number of digits in your final answer. K denotes the difference between every two consecutive numbers. So if n becomes 0 or less than 0, we will add our current number, list.add current number to it, and simply return. So this is the case that will help us loop out of the recursion, loop out of recursion. And now we'll be moving from I is equal to 0 till I is less than 10. All the digits, including like moving from 0 to 10th digit. And if I is equal to 0 and my current number is equal to 0, that forms the case where my the current number that is being generated has a leading zero in it. So we want to skip this case. So skip this case, the case of leading zero. So I'll continue here. Else if I is not equal to zero and current number is equal to zero. So I want to do DFS. and I'll be consuming the ith digit here. So I minus 1, I'll be reducing the digit size, k remains the same, list remains the same, and instead of the current number, I'll pass I. So this is kind of a base case. Base case when current number is 0. Else, if now we'll be utilizing I in a different manner. We have a number which have previous digits associated with it. So math dot a absolute value. So current number modulus 10. This will give us the unit place of the current number minus I is equal to k. So we'll be adding I to the number DFS n minus 1 k list current number into 10 plus I, and I think we are done. So we are using adding I at the units place of the current number. This is a valid case for us where the difference between the previous digit and I is k. So this condition is very important. The absolute value of the previous digit minus I is equal to k. And let me just do the final processing. So I'll define the answer list. New int list dot size for integer I is equal to 0, I is less than list dot size I plus plus ans of I equals to list dot get I, and I'll simply return I. I simply return the answer. Let's just try this up. Yeah, it passed. Let me just submit this code and see if there are any corner cases that I need to think of. Oh, it failed. It says input is 1, the number, the digit length has to be 1, and k is 0. Yeah, so in that case, I have to add if n is equal to 1, like then I have to add in the list 0, because explicitly we are not adding 0 anywhere, because we skip it whenever we see a leading 0 when the number is 0. So I think this should solve the case. Let me just submit this. Thanks for watching the video, and if you have any doubts with respect to solution, please feel free to ping me. I'll be adding this code on my Git repo.